Sodono's capture by U.S. intelligence effectively marks the end of the incident in Indonesia, securing for the Timorese. Intelligence has confirmed Suhadi Sodono's connections to so-called Golden Triangle heroin, has agreed to a U.S. military presence in East Timor as defined by Timorese government. This beginning of what the Bowers administration hopes will...
Cannot underestimate the cost of democracy, nor overestimate the costs of the alternative.
Are we sure it's Soth?
The echelon match from the airport security cameras only had a 2% margin of error.
So this is our last pox box. If Soth decompresses it, our first cycle of infection will be in the thousands. And nearly impossible to quarantine.
What does Soth get out of it? Sodono's already finished.
And what else?
He's already got the device on site. We spook him in the slightest, and he sets it off. It's down to you, Fisher.
LAX International Airport, Los Angeles, California, USA. April 23rd, 2006, 18:28 hours. Neutralized Soth and the final ND-133 container. Norman Soth has breached Los Angeles International Airport security with an unknown number of mercenaries and the final smallpox virus-armed ND-133. Neutralize Soth and recover the ND-133 before the virus is released. Now, greetings, fellow. Thanks for coming back to Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell in Pandora Tomorrow in first-person perspective. This is the final video in this playlist, or at least this game. Splinter Cell has, since the very beginning, had this tendency of having one final level, sort of like an epilogue. Not exactly an epilogue, but a final chapter, so to speak, where loose ends are tied off, and that's like a style of old school narration where stories don't end with the main plot ending. No, you more or less just, you know, give closure to the rest of the story and the characters as well, give them like sort of an ending. And that is what Splinter Cell has always followed since the very beginning, at least as far as the first three games are concerned anyway. Right now, what happened is basically We captured Sodono. We neutralized all of his Poxbox threats. However, as we saw in the last level, he had alerted Soth because he sort of detected an intrusion into his Poxbox, you know, insurance scheme. So, he alerted Soth, and Soth is now on his way to Los Angeles International Airport. How we managed to track him down is through, well, just visual confirmation through, you know, security cameras, the same way we managed to track him down the first time around. So, at any rate, Fisher is now against a, you know, is in a race against time to essentially stop Soth, I for some reason cannot speak today. I've actually had a fever for the past few days, but that is getting off topic. So Fisher's responsibility now is to stop Soth in his tracks and disarm the final ND-133 before it is too late. So, yeah, without further ado, here we go. Time to tie up the loose ends.
Your ride is just about here. A cargo truck that should get you through security and into LAX.
I've arranged for a small distraction. If it comes together, it should open a small window of opportunity.
You make my job too easy.
Just respecting my elders.
And if anybody sees you, you've lost your ride, and the mission's over before it begins.
You've always had a talent for the obvious, Lambert.
Yeah, so I don't know how difficult this mission is going to be in the first-person perspective, considering how there are civilians all over the place, and we can't exactly go in guns blazing with this level. So I'll try to stick to the spirit of the stealth shooter mod, as far as
What's
this game is concerned.
They usually don't check me until the next point.
And if I know, just found it in my task register.
That's weird. I'll see you around.
Yeah, take it easy.
Basically, I'll try to stick to the spirit of the stealth shooter, you know, the stealth shooter spirit in this game, while essentially trying to play it stealthily. It might prove to be a little more difficult than I anticipated being, but yeah. But there are other ways.
All right, Fisher. You're inside LAX.
You're kidding. That was way too easy.
Basically, we've got gaps in the armor. And you're not the only visitor that slipped through.
Soth.
And the last ND-133. And a handful of hired mercenaries disguised as LAX employees. I'd be willing to bet they're still fresh from a smallpox vaccination. So you may be able to ID them by their higher than normal body temperature.
We have no choice. We need to have them dead.
Well, we sort of failed there. And, yeah, we just need to be a little more careful with how we dispose of that guy. I'll just wait for this dog to move here. But the thing is, I cannot exactly harm any of these civilians, but at the same time, I need to harm the terrorists. That's one of the terrorists right there. So that gives us sort of a distraction when this guy comes out.
Great. Grim, you got anything on how they're communicating?
Yeah, it's an ultra-wideband local network, node-based. They've got 10 members online, including Soth.
Then we're looking at 9 terrorists you're going to need to neutralize before you find Soth.
If all of Soth's men have been vaccinated for smallpox within the last 10 days, then it's a safe bet they're running a few degrees hotter.
Yeah, so we just killed that guy, and we know that's the guy because he registers differently on thermal vision. Now, this next section is going to be a little difficult. We'll need... there are multiple ways to go through it, but what we'll end up using is this taking cab right here because the password is stuck to the door. Now, I'm gonna open this door here, and I'm just gonna stand right here. Now, the next section is unfortunately bugged. There are a few different ways to go about it. As soon as we step in front of this thing here, that guy's gonna
know. Nothing works today. Hey, Mark, what's going on with this door?
Where's the security code? Come on, it was supposed to be right here.
I don't get it.
I thought the security code was supposed to be right here. I mean, that's what I saw the last time around. Excuse me? Why is there no security code written on this? It was supposed to be written right here. What the hell? Or is it some other... Yeah, I'm gonna have to think about this a little more. Just a little more. Now, the problem is... If I step here, that guy's gonna, come out. And I suppose him coming out is not that big of a problem. We can always take these sticky cams back, so that's good. Where's the code? There's supposed to be a code written on there, on that piece of paper over there. It was the last time around that I played this game and I haven't made any modifications to it except for the first person shooter mod, so I wonder why that's not showing up this time around. Maybe it only boots up once we actually enter the damn room. Yeah, that was not well done. We need to be a little more careful with how we go about doing things. Checking to see if the light is actually on or off. Yeah, I guess the mistake we made was we did not wait for this guy to write the code on this memo here. Otherwise, we would have probably had the code. It doesn't really matter anyway because he just more or less opens the door for us anyway. I'm just gonna wait here. Yeah, thank you.
Don't think that's a good thing.
Yeah, that is not. So... I don't know whether you guys saw that or not, but that's how you know that guy is one of Soth's teammates. Because, well, he just shines differently. Not this guy, no. That's a civilian. The one we want to grab is this guy right here. And the thing is, we want to do it smoothly. We want to make sure he's in the shadows when we take him out. Like, for example, he's coming into the shadows right now. This is exactly the point when you want to take him. No, you're under nothing. Calm down. You're just under death for now. Yeah, that's it. So, like I said, looks way different under thermal. Like, his body temperature is up by more than just a few degrees. More than just a few degrees, that's what I'll say. I'll leave it at that. And we gotta be a little careful here. There are a few of them. Three, to be honest, in this exact level.
Hey,
one up there, two down
here. I've seen you here before.
I'm new here.
Ah, well then, welcome to the team.
Thanks.
You must be Bob's replacement.
Yep.
Great. I hate to say it, but Bob was a little too thirsty for his own good.
That's not good.
No, it's not. You had a chance to check the numbers for the conveyor tension yet?
No, not yet. Was just about to get to that.
Well, get to it. I can't get started until I've got those figures.
Yeah, sure. I'll come find you when I've got them.
Thanks.
Now to grab this guy.
So, who is he?
Now, the thing is, it's not enough to knock these guys out. We need to eliminate them with a bullet to the head. And, yeah. Like, we literally need to kill them. If we don't kill them, then it's not gonna work out. This next section, killing that guy isn't all that difficult. You just need to time it right to where he's in the shadows. And it's generally noisy enough in this section right here to where you can just shoot this guy without, you know, people more or less finding out about him. However, if you still want to be sure, you can just walk over to wherever he is and check for yourself. Like, for example, I think right now this guy will be a little bit highlighted, but I'm just gonna go ahead and take this light out as well. And now, he's in the shadows. And that's two out of three down. There's one more up there that we need to go ahead and target. Next section, however, is a little difficult because getting up there is the difficult part, and taking that guy out, that is. I'm just gonna make a quick save here, just in case. Okay.
How the hell did that happen?
I have no idea. I have no idea whatsoever.
Don't shoot! Don't shoot me!
So,
I don't think that's a good thing.
Firing shots in this level is pretty tricky. There's a very high chance that you can get caught. Very good question, sir. How the hell did that happen? Who are you shooting at? Why are you shooting, is the question that I would like to pose to you. Are you okay? Like, really, are you okay?
Great work, Fisher.
Yep, that guy just triggered the alarm, I think. No? He did not? Not the smoothest of executions there, but I guess I'll take it. did not have to deal with this guy, but then again, I'm trying to play it as a stealth shooter, so can't exactly avoid it. Seems to be okay thus far, so I'll not make a save here. I'll just go on ahead. If things get a little, well, dicey up ahead, we'll see what to do about it. Now, half of these issues that I'm facing right now is because I'm trying to play it as a first-person shooter. If I was playing it more in line with how I'm supposed to play a game like this, it would have been much easier. So we need to hide behind one of those large boxes there. So this line, if you notice, it does not come with any of those large boxes. We just need to wait on this line so that we can find one of those large boxes and hide behind them. Half of this level is essentially a waiting game. I hope I'm well hidden here. I cannot be sure really. I think I am well hidden, because this guy couldn't see me. Otherwise, he would have raised the alarm by now. And we need to get off here, because these package lines have, infrared lasers that more or less provide security to these things, so we need to get off as soon as possible, make it to this line here, and we need to resolve to good old trickery in this line. Or maybe we could just shock the hell out of the guy over there. Do we have anything? Can't even get a clear shot on that guy from here. That was my bad. That was honestly my bad. Yeah, I'm just gonna take that light out just in case. Yeah, now that guy is hidden, we can keep moving forward. We can't exactly go and loot that guy either. But yeah. We found a smoke grenade and some 5.56 ammo. Let me just go and reload, so that I can pick up some of this ammo. I think I have more than enough ammo, to be honest. Open this door, nothing here, except for the next section.
Fisher, you cannot leave any terrorists behind. This will jeopardize the rest of the mission.
Yeah, I've been trying to perhaps distract him with the diversion cam and see what else we can do about him, but as it turns out, it's pretty difficult to get that guy next to us without, getting a civilian mixed up in the fray as well. And the problem is, as soon as we do anything to this guy, the civilian just immediately knows what's up.
I gotta step out for a second.
No problem. I can cover things here.
So yeah, that's the guy that we need to target. Take out, basically. I'm thinking I'll just follow him in. Let's see how it goes.
There's somebody there.
No, there isn't. Keep moving, come on. I'll just use the satchel here, like, pick up the satchel. Now, let's read for a while, shall we? Not that, yeah. Data. keep this to yourself. I don't want Soth to think I'm not useful. Dropped his dead weight, but this vaccine has been sick as a dog. I'm burning up. You feeling okay? Some of the other guys look like they were sweating. We all got the same vaccine, right? I can't imagine what the real virus must be like. Actually, I don't think it's a vaccine. I think they've just been infected with smallpox to ensure success of Sedono's plan. Yeah, it's tricky, but however, this create the appearance of a terror alert orange, but only notifying third level resources. That is no extra security emergency response crews. An orange level alert at level 3 will affect international ticketing and passenger screening, should delay international flights by a couple of hours at least, and minimize spread to foreign territories. Working on a little something you could drop in the level 1 and 2 systems should at least triple the response time. A lot of people gonna die today. Jordan, a little closer to heaven all the time. The access code is 5325. See you on the catbox, Tim. So basically they're on the catbox, I see. That's good to know. Pulling out the camera jammer. Setting up.
Of course, ma'am. Of course. No, that's not what I meant. I didn't mean to suggest that at all. If you could just tell me your original destination. Hey, you want to give me a hand with the phones?
I'm sorry, I'm very busy.
Just 5 minutes, pal. Come on, I was supposed to get off half an hour ago. Listen, who's your supervisor? I'll put in a good word for you.
Jones.
Jones? Jones who?
Ed Jones. I have to go. I'm very busy.
Wait, what's your name? Sorry.
So basically this guy goes out, but the other guy is the main issue right now. He always gets alerted someday or the other.
Albuquerque.
So what we need to do is first take care of that guy.
I understand that.
And now that guy's taken care of, we just
kill him. Fisher. That takes care of all but Soth's men.
And the chatter looks like they're with Soth.
We're nearly certain he's in the catwalks above passenger ticketing. Work your way up there and find him. Neutralize him and the others, and retrieve the ND-133.
This guy's also in the shadows. We do not need to bother with him. Now then, the only way through is through that room there. Taking the route outside is, well, hazardous, to say the least.
I suggest we go for a short break.
And the only way we can get past this section is to essentially stick to the wall and go behind the screen here. We have this guy, none of these people would be able to see us. We need to be a little cautious here, can't exactly rush through things. Okay, so we wait for this guy, and then when we reach the bottom, we try to make sure that the camera does not see us, which is a tall order. Yeah, we just need to wait for that guy to get a move on, and then, yeah, we can get a move on. Nobody's gonna look at us anymore. That guy's gonna focus on his own coffee.
This is pure madness. Reinforcing the controls again will cause massive traffic problems with no solution.
We have an indication where Soth could be. He seems to have entered the ticketing area just below you. Fisher, spot Soth in the area below using your thermal and binoculars.
Oh, right there.
Okay, we've got him.
Affirmative. He's carrying the last ND-133 box.
Well, the question is, why can't we just shoot him from here itself, you know? Now, there are a few paths that we can take here. One of them would be to just take out all the lights. Which is easier said than done, but... yeah, looks like we can't really take those lights out. I'll just save here. Just in case I need to pull out my camera jammer. Overriding the save. I'll just pull out my camera jammer as well. And that's the elevator that we need to get to. Like one of these elevators, essentially. I don't know where these lights are coming from, but they are hidden. So, just get inside this elevator and use it to go up. Next section is more or less the finale.
The elevator stopped.
Thanks, Lambert.
Soft's men cut the power from above.
Cutting off potential interruptions. You need to get up there fast.
If you can smash your way through the emergency exit, there's a crawl space that will let you up onto the catwalks.
Get to it. We don't have much time.
Roger, boss. So, you shoot this. Jump on, grab it. Grab onto this pole, climb up. Should we just continue on this pool? Nah. I suppose we should grab onto this wire here and keep climbing up. And from the looks of it, I need to climb over onto this side. That's not gonna work out. Just where am I going here? I can't even see how Sam is oriented, which makes things a wee bit difficult in this game, to be honest. Did Sam grab the damn thing? Good. Now where do I go? I essentially need to make it up to, you know, the higher levels of this damn elevator thing itself, but... So there's another one of these things here that we can grab and climb onto. That's where we need to go. What am I looking at here?
I heard something strange.
It's okay. You're just a civilian. You don't need to be concerned. Just make sure you...
It's me. How's the board look? Just incoming flights. We discussed this. Right. What about our Midway and Vegas flights? I don't want to release until they're disembarked. Yes, but are they off the plane yet? Excellent. I'm in 4 minutes now. Out.
Now that that's done... The next section is going to be a little difficult. I would like to save here first. Now, if you look here, you can see where all the villains are.
This really doesn't look like an accident to me. The security guys already looked at it. You'd need a cold chisel to shear these bolts off like this.
Whatever, let's just get it fixed. I'm off in an hour and I'm not looking for any overtime.
Yes, you are. Yes, you are seeing things. Now... You just need to get up there and take care of those guys. That's really all we have to do. I want to try something. Maybe try shooting them from here itself? If that does anything. Where's the third guy? Right there?
Phenomenal work, Fisher. But don't slow down. We're only a few minutes from I don't know how many thousands of dead. Get the ND-133.
Yeah, I don't think there is an alarm situation right here. Like, you can't actually trigger the alarm this section. So, we just need to be a little quick. Get up to the catwalk. Go find the damn bomb, and that's pretty much it. As soon as those guys are, like, eliminated, we don't really have much to bother about. And we're just going to the end of this catwalk, really. That's it.
I've got the box. We still have 11 minutes on the timer.
Damn! That's 5 less than we were counting on. Even my Osprey, we couldn't get it safely out of LA city limits. We need something to seal it in.
It would have to be reinforced steel to withstand the force of decompression.
We'll evacuate the airport. That should keep casualties below 1,000. Fisher, maybe you can get low fast. If the box decompresses inside some kind of containment in the basement, we may be able to get casualties down to the dozens.
I've got a better idea.
Yeah, this is the section where I don't understand where Sam was going. I mean, how would this be better than anything else? I mean, this is a cinematic that's supposed to play here. I think I'll put the cinematic before this debriefing, the way I was supposed to do it the last time around, but I didn't. Ended up not doing that. But anyhow, Los Angeles International Airport, LAX International Airport, Los Angeles Exchange, or maybe who knows, Los Angeles, California, USA, April 23rd, 2006, 20:29 hours. Mission complete. The neutralization of Norman Soth erase the final lingering threat of Suhadi Sodono's insurance policy, the final NT-133, however, remains armed with the smallpox virus and set to decompress in a matter of minutes. Third Echelon scrambles to alert emergency services, hopefully minimizing the damage caused by the virus. Now, here's the thing. So then that's it for today's video, and Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell Pandora Tomorrow in first person perspective in total. I mean, this game was vastly different with the first person mod installed, which is actually quite more different than Splinter Cell with the first person mod installed, to be honest. I mean, it somehow felt like I could shoot much more often despite the alarms limitation in the level, so maybe that was just reckless abandon on my part for the most part, and just being a little more casual overall with the, you know, way that I'm playing this game. But apart from that, this game, it sort of felt a little more suited to the use of the first person mod, at the same time not as suited to the use of the first person mod. But then again, I mean, it is somehow, well, just bastardizing the way that you're supposed to play this game, because you're not essentially meant to be playing this game like a shooter. You're meant to play it in a more stealthier fashion. Even in Chaos Theory, they gave you lots of options for playing it as a shooter, like a tactical shooter, but in the end, they, you know, just made it so goddamn difficult. But to be honest, I'm looking forward to playing it like a tactical shooter in Chaos Theory, which I will be covering after this. But before that, I don't know, maybe I'll be going ahead and playing some Delta Force. as for this game itself, it has lots of glaring plot holes in, here and there, and somehow the story feels like they were about to, you know, give it the Chaos Theory story, which I'm glad they didn't, because otherwise the Chaos Theory story would have been totally ruined. So yeah, there's like a lot of overlap, especially in the communications chatter. But the story given during the briefs and debriefs is totally different. So yeah, that's something that we need to look into, essentially. Not exactly need to look into, but more or less keep in mind the fact that the story wasn't exactly set in stone for this game either, this game or this title either. I think there's like a lot of communication gap that plagues Ubisoft Shanghai, essentially, because it's like Ubisoft Montreal decides something, but Ubisoft Shanghai somehow takes a little too long to catch up to it. We could see this in Splinter Cell as well, when Montreal decided to just drop nuclear power plant altogether and change the plot, but Shanghai, being the head of the PS2 development, got the memo late, so they don't really build the level into the game, and they decided to just keep it in the game anyway. So yeah, but at any rate, this was it for today. Thank you so much for tuning in, thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much for sticking around until the end. This is it. Until next time, whatever video that we might be, you know, putting up, whatever game we might be covering next, until then, take care. Fare thee well, fellow Earthlings.